In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of rotator cuff. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. There are four muscles in rotator cuff. I'm going to explain one by one. First muscle is this one. This is supraspinatus. Supraspinatus. Origin is this part. There is concave surface on kind of top part of scapula. This concave surface is supraspinal fossa. Supraspinal fossa. Fossa means concave surface. It's kind of similar, right? Supraspinatus. It's from supraspinous fossa. So the name of origin and name of muscle is very, very similar. Supraspinatus. Supraspinous fossa. This is origin. Insertion is this part. This is kind of a big bony bump on humerus. This is greater tubercle. Greater tubercle, right here. And function of supraspinatus is abduction. Abduction of shoulder joint. Abduction is this movement. Open your arm this way. This is abduction. Supraspinatus from supraspinous fossa that attaches to greater tubercle. Function is abduction. Let's move on to next one. I'm going to explain two muscles in this section. First one is this one. This is infraspinatus. Infraspinatus. This one is teres minor. Teres minor. Origin of infraspinatus is infraspinous fossa. Infraspinous fossa. You know, supraspinatus was from supraspinous fossa. Infraspinatus is from infraspinous fossa. So terminology for scapula and rotator cuff is kind of simple. Once you remember the bony landmark of scapula, you can remember name of rotator cuff. Simple, right? This is teres minor. It originates from kind of middle part of lateral border. Lateral border. In kind of a middle part of lateral border. Insertion of these two muscles are same place. It's greater tubercle. Greater tubercle. That is same as supraspinatus, right? So that means these three muscles attach to same place, greater tubercle. Okay, then function of infraspinatus and teres minor is also same. That's external rotation. External rotation. That is this movement. This is external rotation. Infraspinatus, teres minor. These two muscles. That's from infraspinous fossa, lateral border, kind of middle part of lateral border, and that attaches to greater tubercle. Function is external rotation. Very simple, right? Now let's go to the last one. This is anterior view of scapula. Last muscle is this one. This is subscapularis. Subscapularis. It originates from subscapular fossa. subscapular, fossa. So same as supraspinatus and infraspinatus. Origin and name of muscle is very, very similar. Subscapularis, subscapular fossa. Okay, insertion is slightly different compared to other three muscles. Insertion is here. This is lesser tubercle. Other three muscles attach to greater tubercle. However, subscapularis attaches to lesser tubercle. This is different. Plus, function of subscapularis is also different. That does internal rotation. Internal rotation, which is this kind of movement. If you think about a placement of muscle, it's easy to remember. Subscapularis is an anterior part of scapula. Teres minor and infraspinatus are posterior muscle, right? So when anterior part of muscle gets contraction, that brings internal rotation, right? So in this video, I explained basic anatomy and function of rotator cuff. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.